the TTB Wall of Fame, our top contributors, thank you so much for helping us making these battle reports. And of course, to all our other patrons.
Welcome to Tabletop Battle. This is Martin.
Yeah.
I'm Svein. And we're going to do something cool for the first time, a semi-interactive game. Our patrons have expressed a wish to be more involved in the battles. So for the first time, we have now made the map, we have sent pictures, we have designated platoons, we have done something very cool, which we will continue doing, I think. We'll tell you all about it in a little bit. But for now, what you're going to watch is 1944, the British.
Yeah, controlled by me, Martin.
You're advancing over the French countryside, and suddenly you see something in the distance. Looks like a command and control post for the Germans.
Yeah, and we need to take that out.
You do.
Yeah.
And also, you have a secondary objective.
Yeah.
And that is to take out the Pack 40 that they have. And also me, as the Germans, have two objectives. One of them is, of course, to protect the command and control center, but also to take out all your armored vehicles, which are three in total. So, two objectives each.
Yeah.
Two balanced armies. I'm looking forward to this. We will show you the table and tell you a little bit about the new setup and how the new infantry support and armor platoons things work. Have we forgotten something?
We'll take it as we go.
That's exactly what I used to say.
So before before we show you the armies, let's take a look at the table. This is a Pedion setup. We've gotten some new stuff in the mail. This crater, for example. And also this beautiful little pond. And I have used one of the hills from one of the hill tiles that you can take off and just put it next to it so that it looks very nice. Also some new tiles over here. Anyway, this is the board, and as you can see with the Pedion tiles, you get some nice square tiles. Some say that it's cheating because you know that each tile is 12 inches, but then again, we are gentlemen and we don't play like that.
Oh.
So if you are one of those guys that would use this to your advantage, then do so at your own risk. Anyway, the British will enter from this side of the table. They can choose where they want to come in. The Germans will deploy up to half the side on the table, up to half the table, wherever they want. I have gotten instructions from my patrons, the German ones, not the German patrons, but the German army, where they want to be set up. And I will act according to that and also their initial plan and what they think about reaching their objectives with what they have in hand. Now, the new thing that we do with the force selection is that instead of having a clan choose only one unit, you will instead choose a whole platoon.
Yeah.
And to be able to do that, we have worked within the rules of bolt action, but we have, if I show you here, we have made an infantry platoon, which you can see here. We have made a support platoon, which you can see here, and an armored platoon, which you can see here. And if you look at this, all of this is a legal army list, because you have two platoons with a total of four infantry, you have support units, and you have tanks. I could, of course, have included more tanks and more support units, since it's two platoons, but we don't want to have too many dice, because that would take forever.
And it's all about the points.
Yeah. 1250 points roughly for each army, like this setup is. So the patrons now command one platoon. It's either infantry, support, or armor. And then they can use the map. I have filmed a short video of this table, uploaded it to the patrons page. The patrons then take a look at that and plan their moves, and also taken an aerial photo of it, where they can draw where they want to put their units and how they want to proceed and all that. We will also do some short updates in the chat groups that we have. If they are online and want to, you know, see what happens, we can take snapshots and just upload that and show them how the battle is going and if they want to make some adjustments to their plan. So I think this will be cool. It's the first time we try this. Be a little bit more interactive. But that is TTB for you. We love our patrons and we do what they want. So let's take a look at the armies.
Yep.
Again. The German lineup. From the left, we have a first lieutenant with the attendant. They are regular and have rifles. You have two Waffen SS squads, 8 men with 2 light machine guns. One of them has 4 Panzerfausts. They also have assigned a transport, a 251/1. And in this infantry platoon, there is also 2 Strafbat squads. They are inexperienced. This is the infantry platoon, and it's commanded by Battlegroup 3 and Flynn O'Flynn. Moving on, we have the support platoon. This is also a first lieutenant. We have a medium machine gun team, we have a medium mortar team, we have a PAC 40. All of these are regular. And in command of this is Clown Forwards, and also known as the Doctor. And lastly, we have the armored support platoon. This is the C4 clan with Commander VB in command of the Panzer 4H and the SDKFZ 222. The British lineup, we have a first lieutenant with the attendant with the rifles. They are regulars. We have 2 veteran infantry squads, 1 light machine gun and 1 submachine gun. Oh yeah, the German squads also have a submachine gun for the HQ. So 2 veteran squads there. These are painted by Thomas Wood. So if you want to have some nicely painted miniatures, you can contact him. And patrons get 15%. Atombe Gaming, it's called. Atombe Gaming. You also have 2 regular infantry squads. Light machine gun and submachine gun for the platoon leaders. And rifles for the rest. This is the Fighting Fives with Alain Jost in command of this platoon. Moving on, we have the support platoon. This is the Hardy Heroes with father and son Tune in command. We have a first lieutenant with attendant, rifles, regular. We have a Piat team. We have a light mortar team. And we have a sniper team. We also have a 3-inch mortar carrier. All units regular except for the sniper, which is Veteranos. Also painted by Thomas Wood. Lastly, we have the armored support. This is the $10 gentleman with Schaefer in command. We have the Cromwell and we have the AEC Mark III. Both of them have medium anti-tank guns with the HE 2-inch templates. These are some real nice infantry killers as well as tank killers. Recce on this one. And of course, the SDKFZ 222 also have Recce. But I'm going to be German and you're going to be British.
Yep.
And that's why you have your camel pants on. I'm glad you wore pants at least. Okay, so we have set up the German defenders up to the middle of the table. First off, we have the mortar spotter, which is over here. We have a 8-man Waffen-SS squad over here. They have Panzerfaust, so they are getting ready for some eventual British armor coming in from this tile. We don't know. We have a Strafbat, which are going to... Maybe I shouldn't tell you that.
don't tell me the plan.
And Battlegroup 3, like I said, they have the infantry platoon, so they also have these Waffen-SS guys over here, which are protecting the command and control center. And you also have a Strafbat back here to reinforce wherever it's needed. Now, 2 words about this command and control center. This is the top of it. It's looks just like ruins because they don't want it to be too obvious, right? But there are 2 ways of capturing or destroying it. One of them is to bring an infantry platoon or an infantry squad on top of it. That means you capture it. The other one is to hit it 10 times with HE weapons with a template 2 minimum. So if you want to shoot at the building, he can do that. And that will hit on A3, and then penalty for movement and long range, blah, blah, blah. But hit on A3 if it's short range and standing still. If you wanted to shoot at the infantry inside, it will be A5 because of hardcover in addition. But you have to put at least 10 hits into that building, and then it will collapse and destroy whatever inside and underneath it, because the command and control center is actually inside here. Okay, support platoon forwards, clan forwards with the doctor in command. This is the pack 40. You have a support HQ over here, or it's an HQ, first lieutenant. Then you have the medium mortar over here. You have the medium machine gun over here, and there's also one HQ that can give some support. Remember, these are first lieutenants, so they can activate.
Yeah, they can
extra.
Snap two. Yeah.
And that's it for the Germans. Tanks will enter from turn two.
Yeah.
Now, we will.
Let's draw some dice.
Let's do that. Should we do it right now?
Yeah, we can do a live draw.
Yeah, do it. Who gets the first die? I want to have the first because I want to have my pack 40 in ambush.
I want to have the first so I can drive past that ambush.
No!
And it's me.
No! Start of turn one. Your sniper deployed on this nice little hilltop. Really leaning into it to get some nice view of the Germans.
And as you can see, he's able to see all the way over here.
Yeah, but he can only reach 36 inches, so don't get your high hopes.
Yeah,
don't get your hopes up.
I'll use my long-range ammunition.
Okay, so you have chosen the first unit to come in.
Yeah, I'm gonna just advance my tanks in, just to get the move on you. Or
get a move on.
What they say. I'm gonna use an advance move. I'm gonna advance in from here.
Yep. That's a $10 gentleman in command of the armored platoon.
I've got a movement of 9 in this.
Lots of movement.
Which takes me in here, and I'm gonna pivot slightly.
So that the pack 40 can't have an angle at you.
Yeah.
But you can have an angle at the building. So I gather you're actually starting to destroying the command post right away.
That's right. I'm gonna use my whatchamacallit, my 2-inch template thingy.
Yep.
On the building.
So that's a base of 3, movement 4. Short range, so you should be able to hit it. And we will then start the countdown.
Yeah. And I'm gonna use my medium machine gun at the guys.
They will have
probably long range.
Yeah.
Just gonna check. Yeah, that's long range.
So that's gonna be 3, movement 4, hardcore 5-6, and
long range 7.
Exactly. So
I'm going to start with the machine gun.
Yep. 6 followed by 6. That's 1-6. Can you do it again? No. Now comes the important roll. The roll to rule all the command post rolls.
Yeah.
Only 4+.
No.
That's a miss.
That's how you know. Don't roll. And Svein is activating his pack 40.
Yes, the doctor is going into ambush mode. So that if you want to bring in some more armored vehicles, I can kick your butt.
Yeah.
And then some.
You may try. Want to do a live draw?
Yes, I will.
I forgot to press record.
No, you didn't. Okay, German dice again. Battlegroup 3 with Flynn O'Flynn. They have spotted a sniper that have crept up, so they will activate this platoon and give them a fire order. It's not the best thing I could do because these have the Panzerfaust and I would want to save them against armored vehicles, but then again, that sniper can do a lot of shit. So I got 2 light machine guns in this squad. They have a base of 3, long range 4, hardcover 5-6, small team 7. So 6 followed by 6, 10 shots. Hitler's Buzzsaw. Are you ready? Well, that's at least
that's 2. 2 sixes.
Come on, baby. And you're a veteran, so you're dying on 5s as well. Come on, I need me some 6s. I rolled like crap with Anders when we played Kursk.
Really?
Like crap! So now I need to have some. God damn it!
Lovely.
No.
Alright, time for the hard heroes, the father and son team, support.
The support unit!
Yeah, I've already measured, so you don't have to see that. I'm gonna advance in my mortar team, my light mortar.
Mortar!
I'm gonna place them over here, actually.
6 inches, and you will have hard cover from shooting coming from here, because of the crater.
Yes.
So, some light support coming in.
Yeah.
And what will your target?
I'm gonna shoot the pack 40
no,
team.
No, don't shoot at my pack 40. That is your objective.
Yeah.
Okay, so I will not unleash my ambush on that.
Are you sure?
So move, no, well, indirect fire.
Yeah.
Shoot and hit on a 6.
Yes,
don't roll
sir.
A 6. Don't roll a 6.
Oh. No, roll the 3.
Okay, so
but
5.
But I'm putting shit in.
5 next turn.
Yeah.
I'm gonna roll me. Are you filming?
Yes. as I was saying, I'm gonna roll me a 6. Because I'm really scared about that sniper. I don't know why, but it's scaring the shit out of me.
What are you gonna do?
I'm gonna fire my medium mortar. And as you can see, this is blocking line of sight. So I will use my spotter before he dies.
Yeah?
And this is the spotter that initially spotted the British advance. If you were a patron, you would have read the intro to this game where I made descriptions for the British army and descriptions for the German army, what they could see and what they thought and how they reacted before we then start the game. So it's kind of cool. It's more interactive. It's more like a little bit storytelling, RPGing. I like it.
But what do you want, guys? Do you want more talking or more dice rolling?
I'm going to roll me a 6.
Okay.
So, mini mortar at your sniper.
Yeah.
Bist du klar?
Ja.
Come on, bebe. Yes! Woohoo! Oh, don't you love it?
Nope.
2-inch template. I have a +2 penetration. You are a veteran.
Yeah.
So I will kill you on 3s. So 2 dice, killing on 3. Plus.
Snake eyes, guys.
Yeah, that would be a very good morale roll. Anyway, you take D3 pins at least.
Yeah.
And I'm ranged in on you.
Yeah, you
That's
are.
That's the main thing. Ready?
Yeah.
There you go. 3 pins.
3 pins. All right.
And ranged in.
Yeah.
Strafbat. They're gonna advance according to the wish of my patrons. In this case,
it's a Flynn and Flynn.
Yeah. Flynn, O'Flynn, Battle Group 3. He's in command of the infantry. So they're going to move up, take up a position of hard cover. I will position the submachine gun in the rear because he can't reach for shit. And then I'm going to have me 7 shots at your light mortar team.
These guys over here.
Yep. And I'm pretty sure I'm within range. Yep. All of them light. The submachine gun cannot shoot, and the rifles have long range. I got 7 rifles. I have a base of 3, inexperienced 4, long range 5, movement 6, small team 7.
Yeah.
So 6 fold by 6 over here. How many 6s do you see?
I see nothing.
I see a none.
I see a live draw.
Me again.
Okay, do you know what to do?
Weiß ich, was ich machen wollen. Or something.
Okay, you know, we'll get back to you guys.
German die came up, and I'm gonna put my first lieutenant in down mode. Just because I wanna save some of my other units for later. If I can find the down order. There it is.
Yeah.
And now you will.
We did a sneak draw off camera, and it was my dice. I'm gonna do an advance move with
your 3-inch mortar carrier.
3-inch mortar.
No. And that is a 2-inch template weapon, so he can then proceed to shoot at the command post.
Yeah, I'm just gonna move it.
I like to move it, move
in.
It.
And I'm gonna fire up on the unit inside the building.
Oh, And that also counts as hitting the building, because then you're pounding on the roof of the command post.
Yeah.
Okay, so you need a 6 to hit. Can you be as lucky as I was?
Well, let's see. I'm gonna do it right here.
No! God darn it!
Oh, yeah!
No! Crap!
Okay, so do we say I just hit three of yours, or do I have to
take the template. We can show the people how it works.
Oh, yeah.
I don't like that. Now you hit that on a 2. Now you can really start destroying it and making your objective.
Indeed I can.
Crap!
I'm gonna fetch a 10-sided die between takes.
Yes, we need that. 2-inch template.
Yeah, I think the best you can get is three guys.
Three guys. So you have plus 2 penetration, they are veterans. It's not a building per se.
Yeah, and I'm coming from above, so you don't get your cover.
I don't get the extra protection rule, so you will kill them on threes.
Three dice, killing on threes.
You know what? I killed the guy, that's a pin.
You kill the guy and you gave me pins. How many pins? It's D3 pins.
Yeah.
No sixes. Two pins. Two pins and one guy dead.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
But the most important thing is you're starting the range.
I hit the building. I'm doing my objective.
You're doing one of your objectives.
Yeah.
So one hit scored, 9 remaining. And there are actually rules in the bolt action rulebook for taking down...
destroying buildings and cover, yeah.
Yeah, not exactly. It's specified in the rules that if you hit a wall 10 times, it collapses. But in this case, we have just transferred that onto the...
the
command post itself.
Yeah. Okay.
So live draw.
Live draw. It's me.
It's you.
You know what? I'm gonna just move one of my infantry squads 12 inches in here.
Oh, you're gonna run?
Yeah, I'm just gonna do a run.
Oh, I see what you're doing.
Yeah.
Meat shield.
Yeah. You want me to just draw another one?
Yeah, draw another one.
Measurement stuff?
Draw another one.
It's me again.
Oh, crap.
Okay, so we're going to do some measuring and moving these guys in. And
we'll
get back to you.
Back. So your first action...
Yeah, I ran in with these regular guys.
Yes. And then you pulled another die.
Yeah, and I did my snap to thingy with my HQ unit.
So you activated your HQ and 2 infant units.
Yeah.
And we allow that off board because we are gentlemen-y.
Yeah. So the first, I'm saying inexperienced, but they're regulars.
Yep.
They're running in.
They're running
12.
Holy mother of lordy.
It's actually just beyond the base of the tile.
But you shouldn't use that as...
No, I'm measuring.
That's why you're measuring.
The tile is actually slightly...
It's a bit smaller than
12. Smaller than 12. So it's a good thing I measured.
Okay, yeah, so that's them.
Running in.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna
give
myself...
You wanna have some field of fire.
Yeah! You're starting to see where this is going.
Yes. So the fighting fives with Alain Jost in command.
Yeah.
And here comes the veterans. And I can see that they are advancing.
Yeah, they are. I wanna have them outside your line of sight from your...
veterans?
Veteran SS unit.
Veteranos.
Yeah.
These guys.
Around here, I think.
And if you get directly behind the crater or inside it, you can claim hardcover.
Yeah.
Okay, so these guys are gonna shoot.
Yeah. I have the light machine gun thingy.
Yep.
And a couple of rifles. And I'm gonna shoot at the guys inside this house.
Yes.
I can actually reach it with all of my guys.
All of your guys can shoot.
Yeah. So do you want to save the roll and do the moves first, or roll straight away?
No, let's do your HQ as well.
Yeah.
Then we can come back and roll.
My HQ is going to do something really simple. They're going to advance.
Six.
Oh,
so you can provide some morale for your sniper.
Yeah. And in addition, they're able to fire on your spotter.
Okay. So let's...
I hope.
Oh, that should be fine. Yeah,
no
problem.
That's
Let's gather some dice and get back with them rolling.
Yep. Shooting time. Okay. So my HQ has moved. It's at long range. It's a small team. It's in cover. Everything that can be shite. So it's sixes followed by sixes.
Yep.
And the same really goes for these guys, because they've moved this long range here inside a heavy building thingy.
Yep.
So it's sixes followed by sixes.
Six followed by six.
I'm going to be efficient and just do all the rolls at the same time.
But the black
The black is my HQ. The white is my infantry.
Veteran infantry squad, fighting fives, Elaine Jost in command, rolling a lot of dice. 11 in total.
Fighting fives, don't fail me now.
I see two sixes, nothing on the mortar spotter. So reroll those and don't score another.
Just six. Need one hit. Yes!
Oh, crap!
Yes!
And I'm inexperienced.
Thanks, fighting fives.
You kill me on three. Roll a one.
All
one.
We needed was the pin.
One.
All we needed was the pin.
Yeah, you got the pin.
This is going according to plan.
Can you lay off now?
Soon. Soon. I'll lay off in five rounds. Or six.
Another one. Another one.
I'm doing the advance action with my tank.
The AEC Armored Car Mark III. This was a very, very good armored car in the respect that it was like a small tank. It wasn't very fast, wasn't very agile, but it was packing a lot of punch. So you're coming in like that.
Yep.
And you're going to move 12.
Yeah. I'm going to move 12 over here.
And then?
And then I'm going to do something.
Oh, you won't tell me.
Because it's an advanced move.
Oh, I see.
You can move and then do
but
something.
I just have to spring something on you.
I know.
Ambush! The doctor is going to fire his big gun.
The doctor is in.
He's gonna fire his big gun at your side.
And all kills today count as class, clan versus clan kills. Since
every
clan
yeah.
controls one
definitely,
thing.
Definitely, definitely.
Yeah. I'm just mentioning.
This is cool. Did we kill something yet?
No.
No. Your sniper should have been dead.
Yeah.
But next turn.
Next turn.
Anyway, the doctor is gonna activate the ambush on the Pack 40. He has. Can you measure up? I think that's gonna be long range.
What's the range on it?
36.
Yeah, that's long range.
Yeah, it's 38 inches. So it's going to be long range. I will hit that car on a 4. So you're really going for it now.
Yeah.
But if you make it, you will get in cover behind the wood that I can't see you behind.
Yeah.
And you will have a nice position for next turn.
I'll have a nice pincer move with my tanks.
Okay, 4 plus. Come on, baby.
Yes! No!
Oh, yeah, baby. Now. It's a heavy anti-tank gun. It has a plus 6. Since it's long range, it goes down to 5. But since you were so kind as to present your sight to me, I get a plus 1. So I have a plus 6 penetration versus your armor of 8. What do I need to pen you? No, I need a 3, not a 1. Yes, that's the 6. And you know what happens then?
Yeah.
It's 2 rolls on the damage chart because now I score a total of 12 versus your armor of 8. So I will now grab me another die.
And film the wall there.
No, I'm filming you. Now we'll film the dice. Only 4 plus, you are tot. That's double dead.
That's not even
any
fun.
Oh, that was very
well. We'll
mark
this one up as a clan kill for the doctor.
Yes.
And we'll draw some more dice.
Yes. I'm happy!
Hey, guys.
Let's show them the burning wreck.
Yeah. I put the tank model back and made a wreck out of it.
Yes, you did. I got lucky there.
Yeah, really lucky.
Let's see if you have some luck.
That's me. Okay, so I'm gonna put my pyat on the table.
Pyat.
Pyat, pyat.
Projector infantry anti-tank.
Yeah. Ace. They're just gonna run up here and
hide behind
get in
the
position.
Forest.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Like so. Hey guys.
Are you back?
I'm back. I'm gonna advance with my sniper team.
Oh, you wanna move them? I don't see why that should be important.
No. My plan is to move them over here.
Okay.
I'm just gonna place this where I plan to move. But I need to pass a morale test.
Yes, you do. 10 yeah. minus 3 pins is 7,
plus
2, 9. 9! Crap, you made it.
Passed.
So one pin removed, you got 2 pins left. That means if you're going to shoot at something, you will start with a base of 3, 4 for movement, 5, 6 for pins, and then long range and cover and whatever. So 6 followed by 6.
Yep.
Since you're not shooting as a sniper now, you are allowed to shoot with both men.
Yeah.
So they both have rifles.
That's 2 rifle shots, 6s followed by 6s. I'm going to shoot at these guys.
Okay. Yep. 6 followed by 6, 2 shots. Nada.
6.
Another one?
Yeah, and I'm gonna snap too, so that's another one.
Well, that's all of yours then.
Yeah, I'm just gonna run a bit. I'm gonna run with my last HQ, and I'm gonna run with my last veteran squad, mm-hmm. painted by Mr. Thomas Green.
Wood?
I mean Thomas Greenwood. Isn't that his name?
Well, why wouldn't a wood be green?
They're gonna run to the hills.
Yes.
Placing them in the woods.
Well, you can't actually run.
No, I know.
So you will be outside the woods. If you're going to move through the woods, it has to be an advance order, since it's counted as a rough ground.
Yep.
And remember, as we discussed, this hill is so steep, it cannot be bypassed. Or it can be bypassed, but you can't go over it. And it also blocks line of sight. And you cannot shoot past this little gap where it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
One whole mess.
Yep.
So that was your veteran infantry.
Yeah, and I'm just gonna move these guys.
It's your first lieutenant.
Yeah, 1 inch from the tank and 1 inch from the unit.
Okay, so that's the fighting fives with our line just. And that is all of the infantry done.
Yeah.
All of your armor done and all of your support done.
Yeah, so then it's the rest of your guys.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Last action of turn one is going to be all German. And we're going to start with going down with this HQ over here. And then my armored vehicles, which can't enter until turn two, will go down. So that's them.
That's 3 of your units.
Yes, and then we will start with the medium machine gun.
Yeah.
This baby will fire at your infantry in the open. The regular ones, it's going to be long range. And we are not giving you any kind of hard cover.
No.
Since this is a medium machine gun and it's German, it will have 6 dice and it will hit on a 4+ because of long range. That could have gone better. That could have gone better. Killing on force, your regular. That is 1 dead. Reroll that. No. 1 dead and 1 pin. You took that guy?
I took that guy.
He's dead. And 1 pin assigned to them.
Yep.
Moving on, we will do my transport. It will move up 9 inches. We have already laid the dice out. And then it will continue to fire on that squad. Now at short range.
Yep.
But it moved, so it's a 4 as well. It will also have 6 dice.
Yeah.
Hitting
on. Because it's a medium machine gun on it?
Yeah, medium machine gun. Yep. So, Hitler's Busso hitting on a 4. That's a slightly better, but only 1 better. Killing on force. 1 that's guy one dead.
Guy.
This could have gone better. And lastly, these guys are gonna have to take a morale check.
Yeah.
They will be hit on a 2 next turn, and I don't want that. So my HQ is going to provide morale,
yep.
Plus 2, they have 2 pins, so that yep. goes away, testing on a 10. No foo bars. That's a 4, so 1 pin is removed.
And you're able to advance.
Yes, and we will advance down the slope and yep. get in your face.
I like it.
Well, I can't stay inside here, and I'm not going to hang back like some chicken.
I'm putting it all out there, and I like it.
Well, you did the same, so why not? So, but they're now shooting with 1 pin, but you will still hit the building on a 2.
Yeah,
so
if I choose this one. Yeah.
Okay, so I will hit you on a base of 3, movement 4, pin 5. And that goes for everything except... No, it goes for everything, because the submachine gun will have long range.
Yeah.
So everything will hit on 5s. And I will have a total of
10 shots with the light machine guns. Yes, baby. 2 shots with the submachine guns, so that's 12. 13, 14. 2 loaders.
Yep.
So 14 shots.
That's a lot of dice.
That's a lot of dice. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready for this.
14 shots hitting on fives. Let's do it over here. How many? Let's take away the ones that missed.
I see at least 6 fives.
This is good.
That's more. 7 hits.
7 hits. Killing on fours. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
What? God damn it.
That's 1 kill.
That's 1 kill. Yeah, well, they couldn't be any better than the other guys. You only kill once.
So you didn't even kill 50%?
Nope. Okay, but now the scene is set for next turn, wouldn't you say so?
I would say so. I'm just going to do an overview.
I got these guys.
They're going to run.
They're going to run. We pre-measured that, so it's done. 12 inches up to here. It's going to be a nice conga line. I need to put some pressure on all your infantry that is coming my way. Wouldn't you say so?
I actually would. But you don't really need to, though.
We're nice guys. Okay, so...
That's the end of turn one.
Yeah.
I can tell you that turn two is going to be very, very exciting with lots of action. I can see some assaults coming on. I can see some armored warfare coming on. Let's take a picture and upload to the patrons so that they can give us some input.
Yeah, then we'll take a 5-minute break so you guys can come with some feedback on what you want to do with your patron squads. And that's that.
Start of turn two, live draw, and we have planned our moves if we get the die. So let's see who gets it. Come on, German. German! No, it's you!
Ten little gentlemen, Schaefer in command of the armored platoon. And he's going to activate his tank first, and it's going to be a medium machine gun round salvo at my hapless veterans in the open.
Yeah.
And one shot at the building to try and bring that damage counter up to 2.
Yeah.
So you will hit on the 3, the building, that's a black die.
Yep.
And then you will have 3s to hit the infantry with your medium machine gun, and those are the white dice.
That's so right.
Lots of 1s and 2s. Oh yeah, baby!
You had to say.
But you get 1 of my infantry and the building.
Yeah.
So roll to see if you kill one of my veterans on a 5+.
Yeah.
Oh, you do. Roll again. Nope.
Nope.
So 1 guy dead and 1 pin. And then we move the tracker up to 2 on the command post so that this is going up.
Hey, guys.
Another one for you.
Yeah, I'm going to fire with my mortar team.
Light mortar at the pack 40. You have started ranging in, so 5.
Indeed.
Miss. Miss. Thank you. That's a 3. Another one.
Yeah.
Crap.
I'm going to do my regular dudes.
They're going to advance into the crater and take up some hard cover. And then I guess you're not going to have a barbecue.
No. Actually, I'm gonna fire upon your veterans.
Oh no! And will you position them so that you can trace a line that won't give me hard cover?
Yes, I will.
So put them to your right as much as possible.
Yeah.
And then you should be able to do that with the majority of your guys.
Yeah.
So what have you got?
I've got 1 submachine gun, and I've got 1 light machine gun.
So that's
and
a total...
And I've got some rifle guys and a loader.
Yeah. 11 shots in total. The submachine gun will have a long range, but no penalty for movement. So that goes up and up. So 11 shots hitting on a base of 3, movement 4.
Yeah. And since I chose the curling charge thingy, I don't get 1 extra shot per third man.
No, you chose blood curling charge. We forgot to say that. Blood curling charge in case he wanted to
assault the bunker thingy.
Yes.
Because
That's what I thought I was going to do.
But you don't.
not yet. But okay. It will come in handy. Okay, so I need force.
Regulars versus veterans, hitting on four. Oh, shite. That is not good. Now, please don't repeat that roll. Killing on fives. Why did I go down? I should have gone down.
Could have gone down.
Ones and twos and threes. And fours. Come on.
Killing on ones five. And twos and come three. On. Yeah.
Yeah, it's three guys. Reroll the six. No. So three guys gone and one pin on my veteranos.
Yes.
Finally, a German die. It's going to be my medium machine gun team. They're going to get a fire order. I will try to whittle you down before the inevitable assault.
Yeah.
Hitting on a four because of long range. You want to go down?
No.
Yes, go down. Okay, so base of three, long range four. One hit. Holy nice. Mother. I need to kill at least. Come on. No, I didn't even kill one! Crap. German again. I'm gonna do a charge. I'm gonna do my inexperienced squad. They're gonna assault these guys. But I do have a pin, so I have to take a test. So battle group three with Flynn O'Flynn is gonna do a morale check on a seven or less. Notice how I use the white dice. Eight! God damn it! They go down.
Oh, that's so lovely, because now you're blocking the other inexperienced guys.
These guys can't see past, so they cannot follow up, which was my plan to follow up with another assault if they die.
Oh, that's so nice. Thanks, man. Live draw?
There it is. Crap, that could have gone better. Could have gone better. You.
Thanks, man.
Hey, guys.
I'm gonna fire with my sniper.
Okay.
Yeah.
So testing on a 10 minus 2, plus 2 for your HQ within 6.
That's right.
Yep, so that's an 8 or less, Quan. Foo bar. Oh, so close, but you made it on an 8. Okay, so one pin removed. You will now have a base chance of hit on 4 plus. What are you going for?
I'm going for this light machine gun guy.
Okay. Hitting only 4 plus. Ignoring cover, ignoring everything, but not your pin.
Is that Swedish?
Well, I will allow you a reroll. I'm not a dickhead. I will not allow you a reroll. Okay, so okay. Killing on a 5. It's veteran, though. Can you go up from 3?
Killing on a 5?
Yep, it's veteran. But if you kill, you pick the target, but that's a 1, so no discussion there. But they get a pin. So they have 2 pins now.
Ich bin klar. Bist du klar?
Yeah.
My German veteran SS squad is going to run.
Yeah.
And that is signifying an assault across the field. I am within 12. You will, however, get reaction fire.
Yeah.
You have a light machine gun, a submachine gun,
fire.
Two rifles. So you got 8 shots, but since I gave you that extra pin, you will hit on 6, followed by 6.
Do I still get the shots even though you fail your morale check?
That's actually a good question. That's a good question.
Do your morale check and...
Let's do my morale check. Testing on an 8. That's an 8.
Yeah.
I don't need the reroll. okay, so you got 8 shots hitting on 6, followed by 6.
Yeah.
No 6s.
Oh, that's a couple of 6s.
3 6s, okay. Can you do that again? No more 6s. No more 6s, I dare you! No, you...
I killed something.
Hit. No, it's a hit.
I hit something.
Kill on a 5.
And as you can see, I'm using the white dice.
Okay, so I'm at 3 pins. It really doesn't matter now, but it will have an effect later because you don't lose pins in close combat anymore. So we are moving up.
Moving up in the world, are we?
Yes, we are. So let's see how this will play out. With two light machine guns, I should never have assaulted you, but...
I know.
What the hell? We want some action, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so I got six guys.
Yep, and I got five guys.
Yep, but I kill you on fours, you kill me on fives.
Yep.
Ready?
Ready.
That is four guys four dead, kills. And I dare you to survive that assault. No, four guys okay. dead.
So one of my guys gets to hit you
that
back.
That is correct.
So I really back. Can't win this.
You cannot, since I was lucky. But you kill one.
I kill something.
That is good for you.
Okay.
Okay, so now we will remove his squad. I will consolidate.
You'll get your consolidation. We'll measure that and shit. And we'll
1 inch!
Do a draw.
That was not good. And what did we forget?
The submachine gun.
We forgot the submachine gun. It has the tough fighter special rule when you use a weapon with assault. So that means for every hit, I can reroll one. Now, we didn't mark out the submachine gun because that should have had another colored die. But since I scored so many kills, we will allow me a roll.
We'll assume that the submachine gun was a
hit. One of the hitters. So this guy can possibly come back to life if I manage to score another kill. Because that will be the guy that you survived with.
Yeah, so if you deny me that dice,
he will stand up.
Yeah.
Killing on a four. That
roll that one again.
Is a cock.
Yeah.
Crap!
So
he's dead.
Okay, let's do a live draw.
Live draw!
Since I have you here.
Gonna be me.
Okay, cool. Do you know what to do?
Oh, yeah, that's easy. This one is going into ambush. Do you know why?
I know why.
Because these guys are in the open,
yeah.
And they could only consolidate 1 inch.
Yeah, so you got that guy in ambush, and that makes a mess out of these guys.
Fighting fives.
Okay, so another live draw.
It's you.
Okay, I'll hand you the camera.
And as I suspected...
The fighting fives.
Aligned just.
They're gonna rush into the woods.
Well, at least advance.
Yeah. And they're gonna fire out of the woods. I'm just gonna place...
At my veterans?
Yeah, at these veterans, because then they're in super short range.
Yeah, and you wanna have your submachine gun there as well. Okay, we will place the rest and come back.
Yeah.
The guys are in position. They see a juicy target. They just slaughtered a lot of their friends. And before you shoot, however, ambush!
Yeah.
Did you forget that?
No, it's a part of the plan. That's why I'm in the woods. Because then you're only hitting on four.
That is true.
And since I'm veteran, you're only killing on five.
That is true.
So
how many do you think I will kill?
I think you're going to kill one or two.
Okay, so I got my SDKFZ 251/1, switching that into fire. And since you have your majority in contact with the woods,
yep.
I will hit you on four.
Yeah, you will.
Ready?
Yep.
Come on, give me lots of fives and sixes. That is two hits. Killing on fives. Come on, baby. One dead. So you were pretty right. Now, let's take out the light machine gun, please. Crap. Okay, so one guy dead,
so you
and you got a pin.
Yeah.
This is important because your submachine gun will actually be able to hit on twos, but now he will hit on threes and the rest on fours because of the pin, because you have movement and that's it. So movement would have made it fours for the rifles and light machine gun and three for a submachine gun, but then super short down to two and down to three.
Yep.
So now the pin up to three and four.
Yep.
So the black dice are
threes
and the white dice are fours.
Fours.
Ready?
Are you ready?
Uh-oh. Killing on fives. Come on, dude. Now have bad luck. Bad luck. Oh, that's not bad luck. You killed three guys. I have to take a morale check. Let's see if you kill something nasty.
If I kill some light machine guns, you mean?
No. Three guys gone. I have to take a morale check. I have four pins. That means they're testing on six since they're veteran. That's
and
an eight.
That's eight.
And they're not fanatics. I did not pay for that.
And there goes my plan to assault your hearty heroes like mortar after.
So you're done for.
They are done. And that's a kill.
That's a kill for Align. Yeah.
Let's see who gets the next one. It's me.
Ooh, do you know what to do?
Oh yes, because, you know, I'm German. German efficiency.
Okay, so, oh, you're moving these guys.
Oh, I'm moving my inexperienced guys that are not... That are not... What's it called? Pinned.
Yeah. So this is going to be short range against the guys in the hole?
No, I'm going for these guys.
What?
Yeah, submachine gun doesn't have range, so that's going to be 7 shots with the rifles. Having a base of 3, movement 4, long range 5, small team 6, and inexperienced 7. So 6 followed by 6.
Okay, father and son, you can do this.
6 followed by 6.
Yep. Okay, well, you can't do that again.
I cannot.
Okay.
Have you met voodoo magic? Crap!
Okay. So, father and son, you're safe.
For now. Veterans, they're gonna get a fire order, and I'm gonna shoot at your sniper because I hate snipers. Really? Like they did in World War II. Snipers were usually executed on the spot. They have 2 pins, so testing on an 8 since they are veteran.
That's a 7.
So now I make it. 1 pin removed, and I will proceed to shoot with 2 light machine guns. That is a total of 10 shots.
Yeah.
Loader, and submachine gun, so he don't reach.
Yeah.
Long range.
Small team, 1 pin.
So, 6 is to hit.
Yeah.
10 shots. Over here. That's pretty good. 3 hits. Killing all 5s, since you are veteranos. That is 2 dead! Yes! I killed with some sniper!
Yes, it's you.
Yeah. I'm gonna advance with my veterans.
Veteranos!
Yep.
No pins, no nothing on them. So, put a couple of guys up, and then we'll be back with the final
light machine gun
position.
That's how far I can go.
Nice shots, beautiful Pedion terrain, beautiful Waffen SS painted by Thomas Wood, and a beautiful opponent.
Hello.
And also painted by Thomas Wood, Atombe Gaming, 15% discount if you're a patron.
Salesman. Okay. So
No. We support those that support us.
Yes, we do. I've moved. It's long range. You're in hardcover. So it's 7 for the rifles and 6 for the light machine gun.
Okay.
Which is not at long range.
Black light machine gun.
Yeah. 6s and 7s.
No, it's a hit.
It's at least 1 hit.
Can you re-roll the white and see? No! God damn!
Yeah.
2 hits, killing on 5s.
Killing on 5s. Oh, yeah. Doing the happy dance, doing the happy dance.
Okay, I think I'll just pause now.
British. Okay, so I'm gonna advance with my... what's it called? HQ?
Yep.
Where's the range ruler? There we go. I'm just gonna advance up towards the trees.
Trees?
Trees. 1, 2 trees.
And then you gotta pop off a shot.
2 actually.
2 shots.
They got rifles.
At this mortar spotter.
Yeah. Long range, movement, hardcover,
small team.
Everything that's bad. So 6s followed by 6s. I've done this once today.
But not again.
Armor power. I'm gonna bring in the Panzer IV. This is Clan C4 with Robert Wiebe commanding.
What's the roll you have to succeed to get your reserves in?
Oh crap! 8.
Just,
or less.
Just mentioning.
9 minus 1, 8. Yes! Robert, let's kick some R's. Advancing. Nice gap here.
9 inches. I'm gonna use my mini machine gun in the hole to shoot at your infantry here. That's gonna be long range. And that is 35 inches from my hull to your hull, which means I will hit your Cromwell on a 5. Let's do the tank shot first.
Yeah.
Plus 6 penetration, hitting on a 4. Come on, baby.
Yes!
So, plus 6 versus your 3, no, your 9. 3 to glance, 4 to pen.
Yep.
Glance.
Glancing.
D6 minus 3. That's a 1, so your crew stunned. 2 pins.
Yep.
Then we take
then the infantry.
6 medium machine gun shots. We have a base of 3, movement 4, light cover 5, long range 6. Ready?
Yep.
2 hits.
Oh,
oh yeah, baby. Killing on 5s, your veteran. Nothing.
Nothing, but you put a pin in me. Yeah.
And that's good.
Okay. Just do a live draw and...
While you film?
Yeah, while I film.
Me again.
Good, good, good.
Good,
you know
good,
what to do.
Good. Yes, now I want to use my mortar spotter.
Yeah.
To spot... I want to spot those guys, your infantry.
Okay.
And I will hit them on a 6.
Yeah.
And the reason I'm doing this is, of course, these guys can assault the pack 40, which is one of his objectives, to take that out.
Yeah.
So I want to make sure that these guys are deaded. And if I get them to more pins, they will hardly be able to move. 6 to hit,
yep.
Indirect fire. Crap!
And that's a 3.
Yeah, 5 next turn.
Yep.
Another live draw.
Yeah.
You're pushing me, man! You.
Nice.
Okay, so I'm gonna use my mortar carrier.
Yes. Oh, you're moving it.
Yes, I'm advancing it.
Okay. It has a 360 degree arc of fire, so you can shoot wherever you want.
Thank you.
And what do you want to shoot at?
You know what? I'm gonna shoot at your inexperienced guys. Those that are inside this building.
Oh, the guys in the building. Okay. Or the ruins.
Yeah.
So that will be a 6 indirect fire.
Yep.
Ready?
I'm ready.
4. 5 next turn.
Yep.
Okay, so for the British dice, my HQ goes down.
Okay. And
then
my,
we drew a German one.
Yeah, one of my HQs are gonna do a run and run into this baby. So that I can have some guys inside.
Yeah, but I can't capture it.
That is true. I'm afraid that you're gonna do that at some point.
Yeah, because if I would have assaulted the pack, then I would have captured this.
That's true. You would have been closer to that than me.
Yeah. So live draw then.
Live draw. And it's me again.
Do you know what to do?
This HQ is gonna run. Run 12, because I think I need some support down here. So they're gonna run over here.
Yeah, out in the open. I like it.
Well, we are German, we're not cowards. And that is you. You're last.
Thank you, sir.
That's the Piat.
Yep.
Last British.
Yep. I'm gonna advance my Piat.
Piat.
Piat, Piat. Yeah, they can move through the forest with this advance move, so I'm just gonna place these guys in
the
woods.
Edge, yes, have some light cover. And then you're gonna
I'm gonna pot shot the
my Waffen SS
veterans.
Okay, so
if I can, I have 12 range.
Yeah, yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
So you have movement and long range.
Yeah.
And hard cover. So three.
Yeah.
4, 5, 6, 7. 6, 4 by 6. But if you hit, it's a plus 5 penetration.
Yeah. That's
nope.
A miss.
That means the rest are mine.
Yeah.
We'll be back with that. 2 last German dice. I measured up 12 inches. And that is just outside the line. So they are not completely 12. So it's going to advance. This is Robert Wiebe in his SDKFZ 222.
And this puts me in a very good position, because now, since your guys are actually touching this tile, I will be within short range, that is 23.5. So my light autocannons can make some minced meat. I will choose to shoot HE with them, yeah. So that I will translate two hits into one inch template.
Yeah.
But of course I need to hit first.
Yeah.
That's a base of 3, movement, 4. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Two hits, 4+. Crap! Nothing!
Nice.
No! Next turn I will hit you on a 3, so don't grin too much, dude.
Well, next turn you'll have a pee out of your behind.
Arse. Last German is the Pack 40. Hasn't yeah. done anything yet. So I'm gonna go for something nasty. It's gonna get a fire order. And I'm gonna choose to shoot HE on this one as well.
Oh yeah.
I can do that. So autocannon shot HE and missed. This one's gonna shoot HE and hopefully hit.
Okay, what are you shooting?
I will shoot at your guys over here.
Oh no.
Or should I? You know what? I'm gonna take out your light mortar team. That's better, because it will be the same. They will have light cover, making me hit on a 4. They will be small team, making me hit on a 4.
Yeah.
So, Pack 40, HE at small team, Hardy Heroes.
Okay.
Needing a 4 to hit. If I hit, you are dead.
Well, you need to roll for it, but...
Can you feel the suspense?
No, not really.
Not yet. 4+. Come on, baby. Yes!
That's a hit.
That's a hit, and that means we use the 2-inch template.
Yeah.
Really doesn't matter, because this is a heavy gun. Medium anti-tank guns have the 1-inch template, unless they are US or British, with the 75mm special rule.
Okay.
And heavy anti-tank guns use the 2-inch template when they shoot HE.
Yeah, so you hit both my guys.
I hit both of your guys, so that's 2 dice. It's a +2 penetration, killing on 2s since they are regulars. That is 2 guys dead, and the threat to my Pack 40 is removed.
Okay, so the Hardy Heroes lose the mortar team, and it's a clan kill for Davai.
Yes!
That's a nice finish to round number 2.
Definitely.
Start of round 3.
Oh yes, live draw coming up. And by the way, Robert, I'm sorry, but you passed. No, you failed your morale checks. So you didn't enter the table from yeah. reserves.
So this card,
it's nothing there.
We've removed it. It didn't do anything anyway, so.
No, it's fine. Now I can redeploy where I want you. That's you.
Oh, thanks, man.
First die, turn 3.
Yeah.
And he's gonna do it.
I'm gonna advance with my infantry squad, veterans. I'm going for the pack. But there's a tiger on the table, so I gotta check for tiger fare.
Well, it's a Panzer IV, but it has the tiger fare.
Yeah.
Route. That's what you said.
That's what I said. It sounded like I said there was a tiger on the table, but...
But these guys think it's a table. No.
A tiger.
Okay, 10 minus 2 pins, minus 1 for the tiger fare, that's 7, plus 2 for HQ.
Yeah.
That's 9 or less, which you make on a 7, so that's good.
Yeah.
And you will then proceed with 1 pin less.
Yes.
And move towards the Pack 40.
Yeah. I didn't move and measure and shit before we did the
No, just filming. Move out the...
So this is the flank.
This is Frank?
Yeah, Frank the Flank. This is...
Me?
Okay.
So this is where you end up after the move, and you now have a total of that many shots.
Yeah. And after some hard calculations...
Maths.
I have one rifled guy who's not as super short, and he needs a 7. I have 7 shots with my light machine gun and 3 rifle guys who need 6s. And I'm going to do the submachine gun later because he needs 5s.
Because he doesn't have a penalty for movement, he only gets penalty for the pin. So that's 4, and then hard cover 5-6, but super short, down to 5.
Yeah.
While the others will have penalty for movement and not super short.
Okay, so the black one needs to be a 7.
6 followed by 6, yes.
6 so followed by 6.
6 is on the white. Pack 40. Oh, that's 3 hits, dude. That is not good.
Yes.
Okay, you wanna save those and roll the submachine gun
on 5s?
Submachine gun
hits 5s.
No, that's 6. Hit. So 4 hits, dude. This is awful for me.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
But I still need to kill them.
Yes, and they have the gun shield special rule, so they are dying on 5s instead of 4s because they get the extra protection
plus
rule.
1.
Yes. 5s to kill.
Yes.
That is 2 guys, and I have to take a morale check.
2 guys, morale check, and a pin.
Good shooting. Okay, give me 2 of those white dice. And I will now have a... They are regular, so they have a morale of 9. Minus 1 pin is 8. But then again, I get plus 2 for my HQ, which is hanging out of the open-top vehicle.
Do you get the bonus when it's inside the vehicle?
Yeah, we'll always play it like that, since it's an open-topped.
Okay, then you get it.
If it was a closed vehicle, enclosed vehicle, he would not get it. So testing on 10. That's a 5, so it's good either way.
Yeah, yeah. We lost a couple of guys.
I did. But I'm not a small team.
No.
Payback time. My SDKF set 251 / 1. This is version D because it has the flat rear. And we don't like flat rears very much, do we?
Nope.
It's it's going to get a fire order.
Yep.
Medium machine gun, super short range, hitting on 2s. It was a gamble. You were hoping to get the next die to bring out your Cromwell. Didn't work out. So here comes the pain. Hitting on 2s, 6 shots.
Ooh.
That is 5. Killing on 5s. Now here I might whiff, so let's see. That is not a whiff. That is what we call voodoo power.
That's 4 kills.
And your light machine gun.
Okay, it's time to do this. I'm gonna first test for morale.
Yeah, morale check. Testing on an 8 because of 2 pins and veterans. That's an 8, so you're a lucky sod.
Still in the game. Still in the game.
Okay.
Okay. So, the Cromwell, named after Oliver Cromwell, he's gonna drive forwards a bit. And
pivot. If he manages.
If he manages the thingy. for his Tiger Fair and
morale check.
Morale check.
So you have a base morale of 9, minus 2 pins is 7, plus 2 for your HQ is 9, minus 1 for this baby.
Tiger lookalike.
Testing on 8. Which you make. 1 pin. We discussed this because if he manages to do some damage over here now, next turn these guys can run up, take cover behind here. I really don't have anything here that can get to them because the tank can't reach them and my inexperienced infantry can't reach them. So he will be able to capture this in the next, or in turn 5 actually.
Yeah.
So Cromwell moves up.
Moving up and pivoting slightly.
Yes, that will still be a front shot.
You have my front and you have my front. If I don't kill you. And I have my 45 degree angle so I can shoot my medium machine gun at the pack.
Yep.
And my anti-tank at your anti-car.
Yep, anti-car.
It's not a car, it's an anti-car.
So this is a big gamble, but if you can pull it off, it will be well worth risking to lose your Cromwell.
Yeah.
So, what are you going to do first?
Okay. First, the thing that matters the least, the medium machine gun.
Okay, that's 5 shots. You have a base of 3, movement 4, hardcover 5-6, and the pin 7.
Yeah.
6 followed by 6.
That's
1-6. Can he do it again? No.
No.
So that just misses, but then you have the important shot with the big gun going after the SDKF set, because if he can take out that, he can potentially also kill Hitler and then take out morale support.
Yep. And I'm gonna need a 5. Because base of 3, movement 4,
pin
5.
K,
Can you do it? Can you do a 5?
Let's do this.
With a black die?
Of course I should use the white die.
Try with the white die. See what happens.
See?
German Waffen SS, they are gonna get a fire order. I will test on a 8, 10 minus 2 pins.
Yep.
God damn it!
So...
They go down? Exactly. Crap.
Was that what you meant to do?
No!
Hey guys. I'm doing the fire order with my mortar carrier.
Against battle group 3 and the infantry?
Yes, sir.
So you need a 5 to hit.
I need a 5 to hit.
And if you hit, that will be 6 guys.
At least. Yeah. It's going to be devastating.
It will. So don't roll a 5, please.
I'm going to roll a 6.
Well, this is how I felt when we played Kursk, me and Anders. I rolled so many ones and misses that you wouldn't believe it.
I need you guys to cheer me on. Come on.
German die, forwards! The doctor is ready to operate on your Cromwell. It will be, as you said, a front shot.
Yeah.
But I do have to take a morale test.
Yeah, you do.
Luckily for me, I still have my plus 2 first lieutenant.
Yes, you do.
So it's a base of 9 minus 1 pin, it's 8 plus him, so 10. Testing on a 10.
Yep.
That's a 9, so lucky me. Pin is removed, and I will now sadly hit Mr. Cromwell on a 3.
Yes.
Are you ready for this?
I'm ready. It's a 2.
God darn it! You and Anders calling those goddamn 2s! Commander Weeby, now you're gonna make it. Your SDKF set 222. Gonna start over here, it's gonna pass the morale check. Testing on an 8. That's a 6.
That's a 6, man.
So we move up to here, this is where we were. That's an advance, and now we can proceed to shoot 2 shots with a light autocannon hitting on a base of 3, movement 4.
Yep.
Ready?
Yes, sir.
2 shots hitting on 4s. That's at least 1.
1 hit.
Okay, so 1 inch template, that's the hole.
Yeah.
How many guys? 3?
Yeah, that's 3 guys.
3 guys, so it's better than if I had shot with only the anti-tank rounds. Then again, the problem is now I have only plus 1 penetration.
Yep.
As opposed to plus 2 with the anti-tank rounds. But killing you on force now,
yep,
with plus 1 penetration. That's 1 dead.
1 dead.
And I also give you D2 pins.
Yep.
2. No, 1.
That's 1.
1 pin and 1 dead.
Yep.
Not a German. It's gonna be an ambush. No, it's gonna be an advance on my HQ. Moving up 6 inches here. And you know what? I'm gonna take 2 pot shots at your guys.
At my guys?
Your gaze. That's 1 and 12. Movement. 4 hardcover 6s. 2 shots sitting on 6. Nothing. But now they can provide very much morale to both these guys and these guys.
Yeah.
So let's hope you get the next die or you will be assaulted.
Okay, let's see. Come
that's
on.
One. No, yes. You crap.
Yes.
Oh. Casualty.
I didn't catch it.
Casualty.
Now you're happy.
I am happy as a lobster.
I should have had that die.
Yeah, because these guys, it looked sort of bad. But then I got the dice. So now I'm going to fire. I'm going to blast these guys, which are out of cover, because I can see more than 50% of them outside of cover. And I am at super short range with 3 of my guys. My light machine gun and my submachine gun.
So that's going to be 7 shots. There's also a rifle guy there. So 7
yeah,
shots.
And the rifle guy.
7 shots hitting on 2s.
Hitting on 2s.
And the rest will hit
these
on
4. Threes. On 3s and the loader's just standing there.
Yeah, he's not going to hit on anything.
Looking pretty.
Okay. Hitting on 2s with the black. 3s
yeah,
on the white.
Hitting on 3s with the white.
Make mama proud.
Come on.
That's... well, the white was crappy, but the black are all good. So you get 7 kills, or 7 hits.
Yeah, 7 kills. I'll take 7 kills.
But they are inexperienced, so you kill them on threes.
Yeah.
Kill 4 and I have to take a morale check, and they will probably run away.
What? What?
No, but you kill 4. You kill 4. I have to take a morale check.
Rolling this badly should not be allowed.
But you do it anyway. Now, the question is... now, I have to remove guys.
Yeah, you have to remove 4 guys.
And I want to be within... plus 2 morale.
Yeah.
Because I'm clever. So I will take him. I will take him. I will take... him. And...
are you allowed to take him?
Yes. Because the next time they move, they will have to move into...
they will have to end within 1.
Yes,
okay.
That is true. So I can remove these guys and keep these guys within cover.
Yeah.
So, morale check with... that's an 8 minus 1 is 7. If you can just measure that these guys are within 6, I will have a plus 2. That I will.
They are within 6.
Okay. So I have a plus 2 morale, bumping that up to a 9.
Yeah.
Okay, come on now. Don't fail me. That's a 7.
It's a
7. They stay.
Okay.
What is that I spot in your hand?
It's my potion of good gaming. Also known as bear. I'm going to do an advance move with the Pjat team.
Also known as the Hardy Heroes, father and son Tune in command.
Yeah.
The support platoon.
They're advancing 6.
Oh, they're
6.
Going into the...
yeah, but I'm going to try to stay out of 6 of these guys so that you can't...
assault?
Assault through the heavy rubble thingies.
Okay.
Yeah, they're going to lie down over here.
I really like this terrain. It looks so...
I know, this
awesome.
this new crater, this is amazing.
Awesome. Or, as Damon would call it,
mortar wound. What? The mortar wound?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, you're gonna shoot as well.
Yeah, you just cut me off.
I'm good at that.
Yeah. So, the Pjat, father and son, I'm gonna shoot at the... infantry squad, the
Wolf
veterans.
SS. Okay, so you have a base of 3, movement 4, hardcover 5-6.
Super short?
5.
It is super short, right?
Yeah, that is definitely within 6.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, needing a 5.
That's a 2. Nothing.
Okay. Hey guys. I'm gonna do an advance order with these guys.
These guys?
My veterans.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna advance into the forest to fire upon those guys.
My inexperienced?
Yeah.
Okay, so you
I'm gonna pass a morale check.
Pen testing on 9 minus... no, 10 minus 1 is 9. Plus 2, that's 11, but you can't have more than 10.
So 10.
10. Well, that's a 5,
that's
5, so you're good.
Okay.
Move a couple of guys and then we'll be back
with
that.
Last guy is gonna be in here. And my first guy can be all the way up here. Yeah.
Okay, so the Fighting Fives with Alain just in command is going to shoot at Battle Group 3, the inexperienced squad. And the dice have been used to see how we can clear the 1-inch gap between that unit and that unit.
Yeah, so there's going to be some crossfire. And I'm going to be able to kill some guys.
Yes. So what do you need to hit?
I have 3 guys in short range, or not in long range. And
one of them is a light machine gun.
One of them is a light machine gun. But you have heavy cover, so I'm still going to need a 6 since I moved.
Yep.
And the other guys, they're going to need a 7.
Okay.
These two. So 7s and 6s.
Let's see what you can score. Oh. Two potential. No, that was the 6s.
Yeah.
Crap. Okay.
So it's a pin marker, and I kill you on a 3 because
yes,
you're inexperienced.
They are very inexperienced.
How about?
Two dead. Reroll that and see if you can take out the squad leader.
No. Nope.
Two guys dead on a pin. That is awful for inexperienced units.
Hey guys. So the British dice, I'm gonna advance with my HQ.
Oh.
I've already measured a bit. So they're advancing through the woods.
Two guys with rifles.
Yeah, I'm placing them outside of cover.
Oh, that's interesting.
Sneaky. 1 inch from the tank, the Cromwell, and yeah, like this. And then I'm gonna fire upon your transport.
Okay.
Because, yeah, you're even at short range. Or okay. Not at long range. So that's one penalty for moving.
Yep. So you'll hit on fours, and all you can do is pin it, but yep. That's always important.
Better than nothing.
That's a four and a five, so yep. It's a pin. German die, infantry platoon, battle group 3 is gonna do a fire order at these guys.
Yeah.
And I have a morale check I need to take.
Yeah, you do.
Inexperienced, minus 2 pins is 6, plus 2 from my HQ, that's 8. That's a 5, 1 pin removed.
Yeah.
And I have, these 5 riflemen are within super short, so they will have a base of 4 because of inexperienced. Hardcover 5, 6, pin 7,
yeah.
Super short 6.
Yeah.
And then the submachine gun will have 6 followed by 6.
Yeah.
Let's do the submachine gun first. Nothing. And then the sixes, come on baby! No!
Nothing.
German, we did some time saving because you only have your HQ left. So we pulled dice until we got yours. So I got 3 of mine. These are going into ambush.
And when he's saying you, he's not talking about you, he's talking about me. So these guys are ambush. Going into ambush.
HQ inside goes down. And these guys, if they can manage the order test on a 8 minus 1, 7 plus 2, 9.
Yes.
Which they can. So the pin you gave me is removed and they're gonna run. I measured the guy over here, gets over here. And then they will follow in a nice daisy chain. And he has to move. How far could he get? Yeah, that's no problem.
Yep.
So now they are within unit coherency and everything is fine. And then you have your die.
Yeah. And I've chosen to use my die on my last HQ.
My die.
They're going to advance through the woods, staying in cover, sort of. And yeah, these guys can make it.
Okay. We're going to make it into the Forest of Doom.
Yeah, and they're gonna fire upon the spotter.
Let's see. That will still pass through hard cover.
Yeah.
So it will be one more turn before you can make that without cover.
Yeah, and it's gonna be long range.
Long range.
Can you just give me
movement?
A couple of those.
6 followed by 6.
Thank you. Team.
Oh,
that's a 6.
Another 6. No, 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 no.
No.
And then it's 2 dice left for me. And that's going to be my mortar.
And your tiger lookalike.
Yes, my mortar is going to fire at your Cromwell.
Okay.
Hitting on a 6, 5 next turn. Yes, 5 next turn.
So well, that's 5 next turn.
And my Panzer 4 is going to move up 9. We need to bring some pain.
Yeah, then more of my guys can see it, so yeah. Using the Tiger Fear.
Yeah, we need to remember that, We might have forgotten that on a couple of occasions in this turn, but never mind that.
Yeah.
It's a very, very nasty rule. I'm gonna use my whole machine gun to take out your HQ.
Yeah.
Because I cannot see these guys over here. So that's going to be a base of 3, movement 4, long range 5, and small team 6.
Yeah.
God! God!
Ah, yeah!
Bomb the base. And then we're going for the anti-tank gun at your Cromwell. Front shot hitting
Not at my HQ.
Hitting on a 4 because of movement.
Yep.
Yeah!
That's a 4.
Oh, yes, you say.
Okay, so penetrating on a 4, glancing on a 3.
That's correct. Oh, yeah, that's a penetrating.
Penetration!
From the front, luckily for you. Killing only 4 plus. Cromwell is taut.
Okay.
So that was.
So that concludes turn 3.
And we'll be back. So many plans have been laid as we move into turn 4. And the British are very dependent on getting the first die.
And the second die.
And the second, and the third, and the fourth.
Hopefully, I'll get all of mine.
Crap, it's you!
Yes! Scheiße. Okay, so it's action time.
Action Jackson.
Yeah, because these guys, yeah, they're going to assault your HQ inside of your panzered carrier thingy.
Armored carrier, and since it's within super short, I cannot reaction fire, and my HQ and his friend has to jump out to defend the vehicle.
Yeah.
So that's a double whammy, as we call it.
Whammy!
So,
okay, we'll measure and stuff, and we'll be back with the rolls.
Or you can take a morale check.
I'll just take a morale check first.
10.
Yeah, because I have my HQ.
Roll an 11, please.
That's a 6.
Okay, one pin removed, okay. And you are ready to assault.
We'll measure and stuff.
The assault of all assaults. The mother of assaults.
Yes.
So you got 3 guys, but the potential reroll on a hit, and that's the black die if that one scores a kill.
Yeah.
You need force to kill.
I need force. Hep hep.
Crap!
Then we fight again, but now we're fighting over an obstacle. Now we're fighting over an obstacle, or... not over an obstacle, it's fighting simultaneously.
Yeah.
So if I die, and you die, we both die.
Yeah.
Okay, 6, you can have a extra attack. Not 6.
What
6.
The hell?
The black one is an extra attack if you score a kill, but you miss again.
I miss again.
It must be the presence of this guy.
Yeah, the mustachio.
Okay, 4, and you are gone. That's a kill.
That's a kill.
So that squad is, sadly for you, gone.
Yeah.
But now I got my HQ outside.
Out in the open.
2-inch consolidation, just move away so that I still have a nice firing line. How did that go for you?
Very, very badly.
Two times.
If I don't get the next one, I'm fucked.
But not from the rear.
Never from the rear. Oh, it's you.
Just for fun, HE at your HQ.
Okay.
So, forwards, the doctor is gonna fire a huge ass shell at your guys.
Okay, are you using your anti-tank shells?
No, I'm using HE. So
really?
So you have the 2-inch template.
Okay, okay.
Hitting on a 4 because of small team. No! I missed! Crap!
And I'm the one who's drinking.
I'm dry. Let's continue the carnage. The Germans are on the advance. C4 clan, Robert Wiebe is gonna advance the Panzer IV. Hull machine gun is going after your HQ. That's going to be a base of 3 movement force, Molten 5. 6 shots. That is 3 hits, which is probably enough to kill you. Killing on force. That's 1 dead, but
one
you have
dead.
A pin, so you have to take a morale test. Yep. Testing on a 8 plus 2, 10. Oh,
that's
lucky
10.
You, lucky you. So they stay, but 1 guy is dead, and you have a pin.
Yep.
And then
it's your main gun. Yep.
But I'm gonna do something clever.
Okay.
No, it probably won't matter because it's going to be long range at them. So it will be at these guys. 6 shots from the whole machine gun. Basal 3, movement 4, hardcover 5-6.
Yeah.
Ready?
I'm ready.
2 hits. Killing on 5s. No. 4, they are regular.
Yeah, they're regulars.
They're actually painted by Paul H.
Really?
Yeah. And 2 guys dead. Oh. Reroll the 6. No. 2 guys dead and a pin on them.
Yeah.
Things are going the way for the Germans.
Ah, so far.
Hey guys. British dice.
Yes. Okay. I'm not gonna rally. I'm gonna advance. My plan is to move these guys with an advance move.
If you manage to order up test.
Up here-ish. If I manage my order test.
On an 8.
Yeah. And I can see the panzer.
Oh, is that, so that's a 7. Good thing you remember because I forget. That's nine, so you fail. Everything goes to shit for you now.
But.
Yes.
I chose the blooded assault thingy. You know what? Let's just. Yep. They go down.
Blood curdling charge.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. You can actually assault with that guy on these guys without them being able to shoot back.
Yeah, but. Okay, these guys go down, we draw an additional dice, and let's see how this turns out.
I will draw on the side.
Ooh, side draw.
Side draw. It's you.
Okay, I'm gonna do that.
Do it.
I'm gonna assault with this guy on these guys.
Testing on a 10.
9+2, 10, yeah.
-1.
Indeed.
Oh! Fubar King!
That's my first Fubar roll.
So roll a die, see what you do. 1 to 2, you can't do anything because there are no applicable actions.
I can't do anything.
You don't have any within 12? No. So he will go my down.
I have something within 12.
No, but it's not within 12 inches of a... of a German unit.
I am within 12 inches of a German unit.
No, but that is not. Because the thing is, if you fail, you mistake a...
My friend list for enemies. Yeah.
But there are no that you can see that are within. So, for example, these guys, you can't see them because you're behind the Cromwell.
Indeed.
But if you could have seen these guys, you can also see these guys.
Yeah,
they are within 12 of them, so you could have. I could have said that you won't shoot them.
Yeah. Okay.
But since you can't see them, there is nothing going down. So you just go down over there, and then we can pull another die.
Yes, we can. Do a side draw.
I'll do a side draw.
This is going so badly, guys.
It's me.
And it's a German dice. Charge!
I'm gonna use my veterans. They're gonna run because I wanna take out that Piot, and now that these guys are down and out, it's no problem. Let's see, they are within 6, so yeah. I can hop over and assault you in rough ground.
Yes, sir.
I got my HQ within 6. That means he provides +2 morale, removing my 2 pins, testing on a 10. That's an 8.
Yeah.
1 pin removed, and I got 4 guys, one of which is a submachine gun, and you know what that means.
I do. That means you get to roll again when you kill someone.
Yes, that is true. So I will have the white die is a submachine gun.
Yep.
And I really hope that we didn't do this wrong, because a submachine gun has 2 shots, but I don't think it gets 2 shots in close combat, because then what would be the point with tough fighters? Because tough fighters... give you 2 attacks anyway.
Indeed.
So the tough fighter's rule is now that you can, if you hit, you can roll again that hit.
Yeah.
So I will kill you on 4s since you are regular.
Yep.
Look at that. Submachine gun hit, so I get 1 kill and I can do that again. Killing another one. So both of them are tot. Ketot.
And that's my PL team out.
And there goes your chance of taking out my Panzer 4.
Yeah, I can still assault it, though, with my whole infantry squad.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, yeah, all hope is not lost.
More German. I'm in the lead in dice, so of course mine will come out more often. These guys are actually going to advance. I will not forget that he is ranging in, because I did that last turn. He's ranging in on me, so I want to move them before he gets a chance.
Okay.
They are inexperienced with one pin. That's 7 plus 2, 9.
Ooh, that's
a 10. Holy mother of lord, they
so
go down.
They go down.
And that means you...
That means my mortar team can still kill them.
Crap.
Ah, yeah. Want to do a live draw?
Yeah, I can do a live draw. Me.
Ah, oh, damn it.
Ah, Mr. Weeby, Robert Weeby in command. He is gonna move and mow you down. Oh, look at that. Vroom, vroom, because now the Piat is gone.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's see. These guys are easier to hit than these. I will go for them. The Fighting Fives.
Yeah. They're not a small team, but they're in light cover.
Yeah. He will shoot the autocannon with HE again.
Yeah.
Two shots. Base of three, movement four, light cover five.
Yeah.
Two shots. Ooh. One hit. That is the one-inch template again. And I guess it will be these three guys.
Yeah.
Plus one penetration, killing on force. That is two dead. And D two pins. One pin.
One pin. Good one, man.
Another German. It's been a lot of that. Mortar. Well, actually, it's the mortar spotter that spots your mortar carrier. And I'm going to hit you on a six. Indirect fire, medium mortar. Five. That's what we need next turn.
Okay, so inching it in.
Another German. This is going to be an advance on my inexperienced. I think I will just move them down here. 6 inches he will get. Yeah. They have to stay 1 inch away from my Tankovich.
Yeah.
I think that will be just fine. And then they will have a nice conga line here. And then they will shoot at this guy at long range. Submachine gun can't shoot, so I got three guys, inexperienced, base of three, movement four, long range five, inexperienced six, small team seven.
Yeah.
Nothing.
All right. Want to do a live draw?
Yes, I will. But I think the noose is tightening.
Oh, it is.
Now it's you.
Ooh, and I have a plan.
Ooh.
Here's the camera.
Hey guys. Finally, it's me. Okay, so these guys are going to do a run action. Because, a run order. Because they're going to assault the veterans.
Mm-hmm.
I've got my submachine gun. Everything's ready. But I have this pin. And he's got a tiger lookalike. So, I got to do a morale check at...
Eight.
Eight, yeah.
And you make that!
It's a six.
Okay, so just drop them into the ditch.
Yeah, because I pre-measured and it's close enough.
So you're gonna assault me with a total of five guys, but you can re-roll your submachine gun shot.
Yeah.
And the reason we are not 100% sure about this is because we continue selling our rule books so that we don't have the rule book available.
So, Fighting Fives
versus Battle Group 3.
Flynn O'Flynn.
Yep.
Okay, so that's one submachine gun and four guys.
Yep. Killing on fives.
Killing on fives.
Holy lord, that is three dead. I got one guy left.
Yep, you want to do the...
Huh. I will take my HQ. He's a submachine gun. He will remain.
Yep.
And
just roll your dice.
Killing on five. No. So that squad is gone.
Nice.
We killed it without casualties.
Finally. Finally.
SDKF set 251 is going to fire at your downed HQ.
Yep.
Taking a morale test on an 8 plus 2. That's a 6.
Yeah.
And we got 6 shots. At short range, but you're down and small team,
yeah.
Making it sixes to hit. That is one
six,
six, and that might be enough because I kill you on four, so it's 50-50.
That's a kill.
That's a confirmed kill.
Very nice.
Okay, guys. This is looking badly. It's looking really, really bad. Because if you see on the field here, my closest infantry unit is way over here. I'm thinking it'll take me a couple of turns at least to get to his bunker entrance. We're still in turn four. These guys are down with a pin. And I can't really go for the capture.
So, I think that will be hard after you lost a lot over here.
Yeah. But I do have my secondary objective. Take out the pack 40.
Yes.
And again, these guys are way over here. So the hardy heroes. Okay, I'm kind of counting on you guys. You have to get up here. You have to take that thing down. So we at least have a shot at victory. Or a draw. A draw is a victory right now.
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, let's do this.
Okay, so you can move that without any penalties since you don't have any pins. You'll also remove my ranging in on you.
I will.
Okay.
But I'll lose my ranging in on the infantry.
They are not part of your objective.
That doesn't really matter. So I'm going to pivot and I'm going to move.
Ever so slightly, so that you can have some light cover from the forest, but still see the pack.
Yes.
And you must also be more than 12 inches away. That should do it.
Yeah, because then I can see you.
And you will also have some very nice cover.
1 inch from the forest.
Very nice cover here.
And I can see you at least 12, yeah.
Okay, this now is good. The this roll is good. To rule the rolls.
I need a 6. You next turn I'm going to need a 5.
Go. Oh,
That's a four.
Okay,
father and son team, next turn you're going to be the heroes of the game.
Your last die.
That's my last die, not you guys watching. Okay, I'm going to use it at my HQ unit, and they're going to fire upon the spotter. That's right.
6 follow by 6, small team, hard cover, long range.
Yep.
Nothing.
No sixes.
Then I got my HQ over here. They will not face off with these guys.
Sure.
They are just gonna run and be behind some cover.
Yeah.
And this HQ is gonna take a test and testing on a 10. That's a 5. They're gonna move into the half track again because they like it there. It's very cozy.
Yeah.
And that's the end of turn 4.
Round 4, yeah.
We'll be back with 5. Start of turn 5. Live draw. And if I got it, I'm gonna kill his universal carrier with my pack 40.
No, you're not.
And if you get it, you're
gonna
order. I'm
gonna kill the pack 40.
Let's see who gets it. Woo!
Aww, yeah!
It's you! Okay, do you wanna have a die and roll a 1, not a 5?
I'm just gonna roll a 5 to take out the pack.
Not a 5!
Oh.
That's the 1.
You had to call the 1.
I had to, because you did it against me.
I called the 2, man. I called the 2.
So I was lower than you. Now it's me.
Okay.
Okay, now that isn't that dangerous anymore, but I still wanna kick off my pack 40.
Yeah, because it is your secondary objective.
To kill all your vehicles, and yeah. I only missed that one. So it will get a fire order, as we discussed, when I position it, he will have light cover from the woods.
Yeah.
Thomas Woods. But so I can still see him.
That's a 4+.
Yes. No!
And
I missed!
That's a miss.
Holy mother of lord.
Okay, since this is going so fast, we'll do another live draw.
We're going very fast. And that's you. You know what to do.
Thanks, man. You know what? I'm going to require both hands to do this, so I'm going to hand you the camera.
You're going to bring out the big gun?
Oh, yeah.
Rock and roller.
Okay, last chance, guys. We need to take this building, so we have some cover from the Tiger-ish tank.
Tiger-ish?
Yeah. And we can't just run. We can't just run towards the objective. We need to take this building, so we're assaulting.
It's a stopgap.
Stopgap?
Yeah, the building is a stopgap in your advance towards
The
objective.
So we're going to try to run.
These are regulars, and they have a pin.
So. And Tiger Fear.
And it's Tiger Fear.
Testing on a 7.
I forgot about that tiger.
But you make it on a 6.
Ah, yeah.
So you can remove the pin, and you can then proceed to assault my Battle Group 3 inexperienced squad with Flynn O'Flynn in command. You will, however, be fighting over an obstacle.
Yeah, so it's simultaneous slaughter.
Yep. You have 5, I got 6, but you're killing me on 3, so I'm killing you on 4s.
Yeah.
Are you...
I'm rolling a black one for the submachine gun.
Yeah, I also have that.
Yeah. So... I'll just roll first, and yeah, so let's see how this goes.
Mm-hmm. Killing on 3s. That went to shit. You killed 2, that's but you 2. Can re-roll the 6, because, it's well, you can re-roll it. Wait. Are you re-rolling it to take out my squad leader, or are you re-rolling it to score another kill?
To score another kill.
Okay, 3 plus. You make it, so you kill 3. That's pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
And you can re-roll the 6 again.
If I get a 6, I take out the squad leader.
Yes. No.
I don't.
So, 3 guys are dead from my side. Yep. I will have 5 white dice and 1 black. The black is a... No, I will have 5 black and 1 white.
Yep.
The white, is a submachine.
Is there a submachine gun?
If you remove that die over there. Killing on force, your regular. And this is the battle we're talking about. Big battle, big kahunas.
Patron on patron.
I kill! Holy lordy! We really don't need to reroll because you lost combat.
Yeah.
I kill 5. And that means that squad is gone.
Yeah. So that's yet another clan kill for Flynn O'Flynn and Battle Group 3. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Robert Weeby. C4 clan, you're gonna turn your turret and shoot with your medium machine gun, because now we're at short range and we don't have to move or anything, so we will hit you on 3s.
Yep.
So at the fighting 5s, try to take out this last chance of capturing the objective. 6 shots hitting on 3s. That could have gone better. Killing on 5s. Nothing!
No, I only kills, gave you a pin! But 1 pin.
Crap!
Okay. Light draw.
Yeah. Moo me. Okay. I think... Oh, wait. I can pivot this guy. No, he's in ambush. Crap. I can wait until they move. I have a 45 degree over there, or I can unleash that ambush at the end of the turn.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see if I get lucky with the mortar, because then I can direct my tank elsewhere. So mortar is going to get a fire order, spotted by the spotter.
Yeah.
So he can see the Heart of Heroes. And I will not roll the small one. I will roll this. I need to score a 6 to hit, but if I do, it's an indirect weapon hitting the top of an open-top vehicle.
Indeed.
That was not a 4. 6. Not a 6. Crap.
Okay, but you need a 5 next turn, so...
I do.
Yeah.
I do. And now it's you.
It's me?
Yeah.
Okay, I have no idea what to do.
Well, you can pause.
My... chances are slim. I think I'm gonna use these guys though, because they're my second to last unit.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, I'm gonna pause and I'm gonna move them down here and I'm gonna fire up on those guys, just doing some measuring and stuff.
Hey guys.
Did you change your plan?
I changed my mind because that ambush with a medium machine gun.
You didn't like that.
I didn't like that. No. So I'm gonna advance up here.
That's outside of my firing arc.
Yeah, and that'll give me some cover for these guys, fighting over an obstacle and stuff when you assault me. And the fighting 5s, they're gonna advance. Moving up here, I pre-measured, and firing upon the medium machine gun.
It's a beautiful shot. So what do you got there? 4 shots with a light machine gun. That's going to be within 18 inches. So he's going to hit on 4s. And the rest will hit on fives because of long range and movement. The submachine gun can't reach.
Indeed.
You got one loader and two rifles. So that's six shots.
But I'm gonna need a morale check though.
Oh yeah. Testing on a nine.
Yep.
You make it.
Boom.
So you got four dice hitting on fours.
Yep.
And two dice hitting on fives. Fours and fives. That is three hits. And that's possibly my whole machine gun team. Killing on fours. That's one, but if you can roll that six again, the whole team.
Oh yeah, turning the tide.
Well, I'm not so sure about that, but
well,
yeah.
Give me some measure of hope, okay?
You were very lucky with that six, so the team is gone.
Yeah.
You can wrap up a kill for the fighting
fives. Fighting
fives.
Oh yeah.
Are you filming?
Yeah.
Oh. now, I am going to move Robert and the C4 clan. It's going to be a pivot. Over here.
Yeah, this is pre-measured, of course.
Of course, that's why the die is there. Oh, I can... Crap, I can't shoot with my whole machine gun then. Oh well, because I can pin you since you're open top. But let's see if this heavy anti-tank gun can make a hole in father and son Tuna. I have a base of three, movement four.
Yep.
If I hit you, I guarantee you, you are dead. Crap!
Aw, yeah.
You can still score at least a draw.
Yep. At least.
Live draw. Let's bring it on. Me again.
Okay, do you know what to do?
Now we will do...
A sneaky move.
We will do these guys.
Okay.
With
these guys, he's talking about these four inexperienced guys. One
yes.
of them has a submachine gun.
Yes, and if they shoot where they are, they will have a hard cover on you. So I will move over here. Just crazy move.
It's a good tactical move, because I had a plan. Now I don't have a plan anymore.
Yeah, I know you have plans.
My plan was to assault them over here and then consolidate around the bend. But this really puts a...
Can trace a line to most of your guys.
Yep, and you're outside of long range.
Yeah, but he's at long range, but still he doesn't get penalty for movement. So the base is four, since he's inexperienced. Movement
mm-hmm.
five.
Yeah, so three rifles and one submachine gun.
So that's going to be a total of five shots.
All right.
Three, four, five.
Yeah.
Hitting on, what did I say?
Fives.
Inexperienced and movement, yes. Come on!
That's three hits.
Three hits. Killing on five.
Statistically, this should be impossible.
Well, at least a six and another six, and I can kill your light machine gun.
No.
But you lost one dude at least.
Yeah. So that's a pain for me.
Yeah, you can move that. And one guy, we'll just take him.
Yeah.
And then we will draw another die. Me again. I can't assault you with three guys.
You can.
I can shoot at you, but that's hard cover. But it's super short.
Yeah, so and you're really inexperienced, so...
So it's four, hard cover, five, six, super short, five. Let's do that.
Okay.
Morale check, testing on a seven, plus two is nine.
Yeah.
That's a seven, so it's good. Pin removed.
Okay.
Fire order.
Yeah. So battle group three against the remaining fighting fives.
Yeah. It's going to be four shots. I have the submachine gun and I have rifles.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a base of four because of inexperienced. Hardcover 5-6, then super short back down to five.
Yeah.
Agreed. Oh,
2.
What's up with the rolls, man?
Hey, it's me. Killing on 5s. 1 dead.
Another kill.
Yeah, and another pin.
Yeah.
Let's take this guy.
Just remove a guy.
A gay.
Oh, this is looking bad.
Now you have your loader and your HQ left.
You want to do a live draw?
I will, definitely. Me again.
What do you have left?
Your HQ? No, let's go crazy. Charge!
What?
We're fighting over an obstacle, so it's a gamble, but now I'm feeling very lucky. I will kill you on 5s, you will kill me on 4s.
Yeah,
roll your submachine gun.
Roll yours first.
Come on, I need 2 kills. No, that's nothing! No, 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 no.
Thank you.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on,
come on. Come on. Yes.
That's 1 dead, that means you win combat. Crap.
Oh yeah.
Another kill for the fighting 5s.
Yeah, lucky.
Thanks, man.
Mm.
Are there any dice left?
I was feeling lucky. Yes, there are. What's left? Oh, I got my half track.
Yeah, your transport.
Can he squeeze? Oh yeah, look at this. He can squeeze past. Move up.
Oh no.
One pivot. Yeah, it was around here.
Yeah, that's okay.
And brup, hardcover.
Hardcover, but not long range.
6 shots.
You moved.
And hardcover,
and
so
hardcover.
6.
Yep.
Well, I'm whittling you down. 1, so that's another pin.
Yep.
Killing on 5. There you go, another guy dead.
That's the loader.
That's the loader.
And another pin. Oh, this is looking so bad.
That it is.
Okay. Are there any more dice?
Oh yes, you got 1, you got your HQ.
Yeah.
And I got my HQ.
That's and me. It's your HQ.
You know what? I will not risk them, so they go down inside.
Okay.
And then you got your HQ.
Yeah. And they're gonna fire upon your spotter.
So that's gonna be a 6 followed by 6 again.
Yeah.
Nothing.
That's nothing.
And that means we move into turn 6. We'll be back after we have reset the table. Start of turn 6.
Okay.
Let's see how this epic battle will end. 1250 points.
If I don't get the first dice now, this looks really, really bad for me. I can manage a draw, but
you can.
Yeah.
1250 points has been up against each other. Germans had the advantage of claiming some hardcover early in the game, but then again, you had the advantage of being able to choose where you want to come in. I was spread out.
Yeah.
But I had some luck in the beginning, so you lost a couple of important units there. It's you!
Ah, yeah.
This can be the draw of all draws. If you can manage to score a hit on the pack 40.
I'm down to a 4.
You are down to a 4, are you not?
Yep.
Because you shot first when you moved, and then previous round and this round.
Yeah.
So 4, can you make it? No, that's another 1! You are cursed! You are cursed! It's not the meaning that you're going to win this.
No.
Or draw it.
I don't think that's... Yep.
Then it's me.
You don't know what to do?
Oh, I know what to do.
Pack 40?
Pack 40. Kill that thing and score an objective.
Yeah, you need a 4.
I need a 4. Crap! Another die.
The hardy heroes. They're gonna do this, you know.
It's you.
They're gonna turn the tide. That's me.
Yes.
Oh.
HQ or these guys?
I think I'm gonna go with those guys.
Yeah, what are they gonna do?
The fighting 5s?
Yeah.
You know what?
Assault?
They're gonna make minced meat out of you. They're gonna shoot you.
Oh.
Yeah. If they manage their morale check.
Yeah, on a 7.
I can't see the tigers, so that's cool.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
That's a 7.
That's a
so you
7.
Make it. 1 pin removed.
Yeah, and they're gonna fire up on those guys out of cover.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm just gonna hand you the camera and we'll roll some dice.
Okay. So, the Fighting Fives. I have no chance of winning this game, but I'll go for a draw. I'm going to take out Finofin and his guys.
Shooting with the light machine gun with the minus loader, so that's hitting on a base of 4, 2 pins, 6.
Yep.
Submachine gun has long range and...
and 2 pins.
2 pins, so also 6.
So also 6.
6 shots hitting on 6s. Scoring that's a hit.
One hit.
Killing on 3s.
That's a 3.
So one guy dead and a pin.
Yep.
The roll to rule all the rolls. The Tiger Fear, Panzer 4. Panzer Robert Weavy, C4 clan, is gonna settle the matter. He's gonna hit on a 3.
Yeah, because you're standing still and I'm right over here.
Yes, and if I hit, that thing is probably destroyed and you will have no chance, if there even is a turn 7, to do something to that one or that one, which means we can call the game.
I know.
So, the rule to roll all the rolls and rules. On a 3. Yes!
That's a 3.
Plus okay. 6 versus 7. So anything but a 1.
Yeah. 2 plus.
5! That is...
And that's game. Alright.
No.
We still have the damage charge thing.
Yeah, but it's 6 plus 5 is 11. So that's 3 above your armor. I will roll 2 times on the damage charge.
Yeah.
And that is a that destroyed game. Mortar carrier. The Hardy Heroes is gone.
Yeah.
And that is game win for the Germans. I had luck, like I said. We will be back with a summary.
Yep.
Okay, guys. So for the post-game report, Germany had it.
They had. Like I mentioned a couple of times, I got luck in the beginning, took out your AEC armored car.
Yeah.
And also when you started your creep up here with your infantry, that I managed to take them out so that you could not reach the pack 40.
I was so close though.
You were very close. And that would have scored you 3 points.
Yeah.
And if you had managed to capture that as well, another 3 points for a total of 6.
Yeah.
Instead, it was the Germans that took that. By destroying the
infantry squad, really, that was the turning point. When your HQ took out my infantry squad, if that had been the other way around, I would have taken out your transport. I could have just turtled in with the mortar.
Lots would have happened over on this side then. But like I said, instead, I managed my secondary objective, which was to destroy all the British vehicles.
Yeah, that's 3 points.
And I also defended my command post.
Yeah, that's another 3 points. Overwhelming victory.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So what could you have done differently?
Well, you know, I could have used all my vehicles on the right flank and them being safe for the pack 40, from the pack 40. Or I could have focused more on my left flank and done a whole flank around this side of the battlefield.
Yeah.
There's a lot of things that could have been done differently. But I had fun.
It was very fun.
That's the important part.
That's the important part. And I was a bit scared when you started to hit the building and the counters started going up. But then you switched tactic and tried to do the other way around. So that was good.
I did a bit of math and I could afford one miss.
Yeah. Yeah.
When you took out my other tank,
it was better to go for trying to go for the pack 40 then.
Yeah.
But we also discussed that it would be very cool to play the game again and then switch sides.
Yeah.
Since it was very very even up until the point where
where it all turned.
Yeah. So it would be cool to do it again.
Anyone's game.
Yeah, and then you could be German, I could be British, because I also have some ideas what would I do, and you have some ideas for Germans.
Yep.
So we will see if we do that. And anyway, we hope you like this. This was the first
semi-interactive
game.
Yeah.
Of course, you have to be a patron to be part of that. You can visit patreon.com/tabletopbattle and see if there's something for you there, if you want to support us. And take part in the fun and the mayhem and, help us continue making these battle reports.
Yeah.
So this has been Martin.
and Svein, and we're Tabletop Battle. Thank you for watching.